students and faculty from opera workshop and collaborative piano classes. Our scenes are usually presented in the recital hall, but today we are excited to be able to perform in this large hall for you. We would like to thank the Bologna Performing Arts Center staff for their assistance in making this performance as a valuable experience for everyone involved. It has been about 1 year since we had to cancel our scenes program in spring 2020, so we are super grateful that we are able to share this beautiful music with you all. Our first scene is Ain't It a Pretty Night, from an opera in two acts, Susanna, by American composer Carlisle Floyd. Floyd also wrote the libretto based on the story of Susanna and the Elders. The opera is sung by the titular character Susanna Polk, an 18-year-old innocent girl in Act 1, Scene 2. Living in the small town of New Hope Valley, Tennessee, she is expressing her excitement for how beautiful it is in her hometown, but nonetheless, she still wants to leave and explore the world beyond them mountains. Caitlin Murphy is going to play the role of Susanna, and the collaborative pianist for this piece will be Dr. Shimizu. Enjoy! and final act of Dido and Aeneas by Henry Purcell. Before the aria takes place, Dido's lover Aeneas has considered leaving Carthage at the request of who he believes to be God. This upsets Dido because he has thought of leaving her. Although Aeneas offers to stay, Dido refuses and tells him to leave. She dies as his Trojan ship leaves the harbor. We have Amber Browning as Dido and Haley Brooks as our collaborative pianist. Enjoy.
I have been. consulting a friend, Dr. Malatesta, to see if it is possible. Malatesta is lying to Pasquale about a beautiful woman he will find. The next three scenes are from L'Annunzio del Figaro, an Italian comedic opera composed by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. It tells of how servants Figaro and Susanna succeed in getting married, fooling the efforts of their plundering employer Count Alvavia to seduce Susanna and teaching him a lesson in infidelity. Porgi Amor quel che resto is an aria sang by the Countess at the beginning of Act Two. When she appears for the first time in the opera, she is meditating on the Count's infidelity. Love, give me some remedy for my sorrow and sadness. Give me my back, my daughter, or at least let me die. Thank you.
Carabino's appearance, make him look like a female. The piece starts with Susanna desperately trying to get Carabino to pay attention and keep still while she is fixing the hair and quotes. Finally, she gets the job done and begins bragging on how great the lady he makes. She even says that if a woman would fall in love with him, she can see the reason why.
Next, we will present Duettino and Recitativo. Susanna is trying to help Carabino escape before the Count can find him. Carabino scrambles around to figure out how to leave. All of the doors are locked, so Carabino resorts to jumping out of the window. Susanna tries to stop him and help him escape a safer way, but it is too late when he jumps out before she can get to him. Once Carabino jumps from the window, Susanna sees him land safely on the ground and begins to run as fast as he can. At this, Susanna begins to laugh, but quickly realizes there is no time to waste, and she must hurry and hide before the Count returns with a crowbar in order to open the locked dressing room.
Mm-hmm. are sung in the beginning of Circe by George Frederick Handel. A Persian king named Circe is given praise to a tree that is giving him shade. The tree symbolizes many things for the king, such as shelter and protection during a terrible storm. The recitative means tender and beautiful branches of my beloved plane tree. For you, fate brightly shines. Thunder, lightning, and storms never disturb your majestic calm. Rapacious winds do not reach out to defile you. And the aria means never was there a shadow of branches sweeter, more refreshing, or more gentle. Tico Jones is Circe, collaborative pianist Dr. Kamiko Shimizu.
Thank you.
birthday celebration to which he arrives in disguise. This scene takes place during the first act when his party concludes. A pair of poor street singers, Paquillo and La Pacarole, enter to raise money for their marriage license by entertaining the crowd. We have Tristan Gooden as Paquillo and Amber Browning as La Pacarole. Our collaborative pianist is Dr. Shimizu, and our tambourine players are Haley Brooks and Cameron Sullivan. Enjoy! Is from an operetta, Die Fledermaus, by Johann Strauss II. Gabriel von Eisenstein and Dr. Falke are friends and have a story that has prompted Dr. Falke to take revenge on Eisenstein. As one of the arrangements made for revenge, Rosalind, Eisenstein's wife, is introduced to the party at the masquerade ball as a Hungarian countess, which she is not. She tries to convince the partygoers that she is actually a Hungarian countess by singing this aria as a sentimental dance song dedicated to her love of her home country. Caitlin Murphy is Rosalind, and the collaborative pianist is Dr. Schmitz.
Thank you.
duet from the three short story opera, The Tales of Hoffmann by Offenbach. It is sung at the beginning of the third act by a courtesan, Julieta, and Nicholas Hoffman's muse. Disguised as his friend, set in Venice, the two characters sing about the romantic night of love. The Grove Book of Operas considers this duet as one of the world's most popular melodies. Caitlin Pignataro plays Julieta, and Zatamius Jones plays Nicholas. Their collaborative pianist is Andrew Wasolina. This scene completes our Scenes program, and I hope you have enjoyed our performances. We thank you very much for coming and supporting our efforts in opera, in person or virtually.